Drought in the south and dangerous heat in the northeast. This week's deadly heat wave is responsible for nearly two dozen deaths. And for days now, it's been oppressively hot. Air quality has been poor. Well, for a scientific perspective of this record-breaking heat wave, we turn to Reese Halter, our conservation biologist. Welcome, Reese. Good morning.
Good morning, Alex. You know, each day on Earth, we've got 90 million tons of carbon pollution that are spewing into the atmosphere. We've taken climate change and we're now dealing with climate disruption. Corn, due to a relentless heat and a late planting, is at an all-time record high. We're looking at a 16-year low on the harvest. 6.5 million tons of hay have been killed by this drought. That means that 4 million cattle this winter will be supplementally fed. Rising food prices due to climate disruption are what the voters are going to be faced with this fall. And the lawmakers in D.C. need to wake up and get that the economy is wholly owned subsidiary, Alex, of the environment.
It's an interesting perspective you offer there, Reese. But, you know, there are a lot of people going to say, look, it's the summer, no big deal. You got to expect these kinds of heat waves. Is this normal or is this a new normal?
This is a new normal. Look, if we go up to the Arctic, the average temperature, Alex, is 14 degrees higher than normal. Each day in July, we're missing 46,000 square miles of ice, or the area equivalent to Pennsylvania. This is awful, Alex.
Yeah, so it's been damaging to the environment over all this heat.
Awful, awful. And remember, there was a huge chunk of ice from the Petermann Glacier that broke off Greenland last August. It's now floating in the North Atlantic off Labrador, Canada, heading into the international shipping lane.
Yeah, all right. Well, thanks for the heads up on that, Reese Halter. Interesting as always.